of the day, as an investor, when I look at any new product, should I add it in my portfolio or not? What should be my filtering criteria? That for everything else being equal, is it going to, you know, likely to enhance my returns? Or for all else being equal, will I get the same return at lesser volatility? I would like to position this product in the second bucket. So investors who are expecting very high returns, I don't think this is the right product for them. I'll, you know, be very honest upfront. This is a more, this is a fund designed for lesser volatility, lower fluctuations. And lastly, what we try to do always is we have ourselves learned that most often backtesting models, have some bit of exuberance in it because it's not in the real world. But we try to solve for that by, you know, testing our data points in a real world by assuming a certain amount of size, certain amount of liquidity constraints. We don't give the highest weight to the best performing stock because we realize that the best stock may be a small stock and maybe a small part of the benchmark. So even our weights would be, constrained along with that so that we are more real. And we have loaded a cost of around 3% on our backtesting. So whatever returns we have posted in our slides are after netting off a 3% cost, whereas the actual cost will be 1.6%, 0.8 and 1.6, direct plan and regular plan for our investors. Yeah. So we try to be more conservative in our backtesting because we would rather underpromise and deliver rather than, you know, overpromise and still deliver.
And I like the fact that in the presentation you've given, you know, you've on, what is it, slide number 19? Yeah, slide number 19. You've actually given scenarios. You've given what happens to the portfolio in taper tantrum, what happens to it during demonetization, and what happened most recently with this COVID-19 that we've had. And the value strategy is actually somewhere, you know, somewhere probably in the middle of, it's exactly what you were saying. So even though you've backtested it, you've probably taken real life scenarios.
So Anupam, great point you highlighted. See, what I want to highlight, a lot of investors who are coming in new today, and, you know, I'll fast track the last 20 years for all of them, is we've seen in India in the first decade between, let's say, 2000 to 2010 or 2003 to 2008, where Indian markets went up 7 times in 4 years. Small caps went up 15 times in 4 years. We were at a 10p, a 10p market went to 30p. May not happen, again. So the first decade belonged to emerging markets and, India clearly versus the developed world.